Oh, where could it be? I'm sure I saw it. Oh, hello. My name's Ellie. Welcome to HT Kids at Home, and I really need your help. Yesterday, I'm sure that I saw this like bright pink bird with a yellow beak, but no one believes me. But I did see it, and I'm sure I'm gonna see it again. So I need your help. I'm gonna keep an eye out for it and see if you can see it too. Lightning bolt, but pink. That was definitely the bird. I tell you what we do. How about we sing the action song next, and while we're singing, maybe the bird will come back again. See you in a bit. Well done, everyone. That was great singing. I still haven't seen any sign of the bright pink bird with the yellow beak, though. Maybe I'll just keep looking. Maybe it's up here. See, how can I miss it? It's so pink. Can't see it anywhere, though. I tell you what, how about next we do our game and hear our story, but keep your eyes peeled to see if you can see the bird. I'm sure it must be in here somewhere. No sign anywhere. Oh well, see you in a bit.
I'm Hannah and I lead in Launchpad. Now it's time for our game, and it's a Launchpad favourite, the Mr. Man game. Who remembers how to play? I say a Mr. Man and you have to do the action for it. So if I say Mr. Tall, I want you all to reach up really high and be as tall as you can. And if I say Mr. Small, we're all going to crouch down in a little ball and be small. And if I say Mr. Fast, we're all going to run really, really fast. And if I say Mr. Slow, we're going to run in slow motion. And if I say Mr. Bounce, we're all going to bounce. Bounce, bounce, bounce. And last one, if I say Mr. Jelly, we're all going to wobble like a jelly. Wobble, wobble, wobble. Okay, so let's start. Mr. Bounce. Did you all bounce? Bounce, 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 bounce. I hope you're all bouncing. Mr. Tall. Stretch up tall. Mr. Jelly. That's right. Wobble, 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 wobble. Like a jelly. Mr. Small. Is everybody being as small as they can? Hope so. Mr. Fast. Come on, let's run as fast as we can. And Mr. Bounce. Bounce, bounce, bounce. And Mr. Jelly. I hope you're all getting tired. Mr. Fast again. Fast, 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 fast. And slow. Very good. Well done, everybody. Now I'm tired, I think it must be story time. But it doesn't look very comfy here. Maybe I need to get some chairs and a couple of friends to help me read. Ah, that's better. Well done, everyone. Take a seat. It's time for us to read our story. Do you remember what book of the Bible we're reading from? It's near the start and it's a book called Exodus, and it's all about Moses. Last week, we saw God rescuing his people from Egypt. But what happens next? Let's find out. Oh, sorry, Bernard. It says, God's people were a bit stuck. They had walked a long, long way, all the way to the shore of a wide, deep sea. That's the way we need to go, they said, pointing across the sea. But it was too wide and too deep to swim. How would they get across? Suddenly, everything got a lot worse. In the distance, they heard horses neighing and galloping. They heard people shouting. Oh no, Pharaoh was chasing them with a huge army. But God made a path through the waters of the deep, wide sea. He split it in two, and his people were able to walk through it on a safe path. On either side was a huge wall of water and they could see fish swimming around. Just as the last of God's people arrived safely on the other side, God let the water fall again. Crash! It splashed right into the wide deep sea, right onto Pharaoh's army. But God's people were safe. Now, I'm going to hand over to Hannah, who's going to talk to us about the story we've just read. So, over to you, Hannah.
Well, good morning, everyone. My name is Hannah, and I'm from the HT Kids team. I hope that you enjoyed playing the game and listening to the story. I wonder whether you can remember what happened in our story a whole week ago. God's people left Egypt and started on a really long walk in the desert. And this week, where did they end up on their walk? At the seaside. Have you ever been to the seaside? When we go, we might go for a swim in the sea, or we might eat some ice cream, or we might build a sandcastle. It's really fun when we go to the seaside. But this trip to the seaside wasn't fun for God's people at all. They were stuck. There was a big sea in front of them and they needed to go across it to get to the land on the other side. But they couldn't go over it. They didn't have any boats. They couldn't go under it. They couldn't swim. They couldn't go round it because it was much too big. But the biggest problem was that they couldn't turn back and go the way they had come because there was a big army chasing them. Pharaoh, the king of Egypt, who had said that God's people could leave, had changed his mind again. He didn't want God's people to leave, so he had sent his big scary army to chase them. So God's people had only one option. They would have to go through the sea. But how? And at this moment, when God's people were really stuck and really scared, God did something amazing. He pushed the water back in the sea to either side so that there was a straight path that God's people could walk through. And as they walked through, the water stayed on either side of them, so they were safe. And I think they would have been able to see some of the animals that were in the sea, like the fish and the starfish, and maybe even a jellyfish. Can you think of anything else that lives in the sea? God's people walked through the sea and got to the other side safely. And when they were safe, the water came down with a big crash on top of the army that had been chasing them. So the army couldn't chase them anymore. God's people were really stuck and didn't know what to do, but God had a plan and he rescued them and kept them safe. Sometimes we can feel stuck too, but we can ask for God's help and he will rescue us too. Well, I think it's time now to hand back to Ellie so that she can tell us what our leader challenge of this week is.
Oh, hello. Good to see you all again. Guys, I've been looking all day for this pink bird and you know, I can't see it anywhere. And I really just don't understand because it's such a bright pink bird. How can I not have seen it? And the beak is so yellow and I just still haven't seen it anywhere. It's the pink bird! This is so exciting! And look, I'm so close up to nature in its natural habitat. Wow, this is so exciting. And this has given me an amazing idea for our leader challenge for this week. Why don't you go on a nature hunt? Why don't you go outside and see what you can see? You might need to use your binoculars to see if you can see any birds, or you could go and see what flowers you can spot, or what trees you could spot, or even what creepy crawlies you could spot. So next it is time for us to do our craft. So head on over to the website to go and see what Red Sea themed crafts you can find. And we love seeing your photos and your crafts, so please do keep sending them into our Facebook page. It's time for us to go next, but before we do, let's pray together. Father God, thank you that you made a way for us to be with you. Thank you that we can trust you and you can do the impossible. Amen. Amazing. Thanks for coming, everybody. Hope you have a great Sunday and see you next time.